Cool, yeah, so I've just been messing around with this. I had this concept, Mushrooms from Hell, which is from one of my favourite computer games, Monkey Island. As Guybrush descends into the monkey head and gets to hell, the first thing he sees is loads of mushrooms. And he says, I had a feeling that in hell it would be mushrooms. Yeah. So, job update, wasn't it? So yeah, so that's, and it's supposed to be some kind of blob adventure, but cool. I've just been using it really to practice SAS and Git, and I've got everything on GitHub. My first ever repository going on.
Woo!
Exciting times. So yeah, it's mainly concentrating on design. I did the logo based on, the original screenshot. So I basically nicked the colours from this and I just made like a simple thing in Photoshop to get that, and that's how I kind of developed the colour scheme and all that. So it's really simple, it's just one page at the moment. I've just tried to mess around with some JavaScript and stuff, so I've got some cool stuff going on soon, hopefully it works. Yeah.
Oh, nice.
That's basically what I've got, and some dummy content with mushrooms.
And that's all written completely, you've done it yourself?
Yeah, so it's all myself. Yeah. It's JavaScript, there's no jQuery. Yeah. I'm happy with that.
The CSS transition.
Yes, CSS transitions with JavaScript triggering it. Yeah. Yeah, cool. So that's the actual website. So I've been using Sublime Text, and I've tried to use SAS, as I was saying earlier. So I've got all my SAS arranged in. I've got all these partials, so all this stuff kind of adds up to this main .scss, and then that's importing everything else.
Can you make the font a bit bigger, dude?
I don't do that.
Control S.
Oh, yes!
Yes!
Nice one.
Yeah, so this is the main CSS, this is the main SAS file, and it's just importing from. The idea that I've kind of got going is that everything in the partials folder is going to be things that I can kind of bring over to other projects, so that's kind of why I like SAS. And I mean, I guess I could do it with CSS, but it means that I've got everything in arranged in little modules. So like, for example, I've got this grids.scss, which is, I showed you guys on Slack, which is this is the only thing that I did steal from Skeleton Framework, which I then deleted everything that I kind of didn't understand, and I've I do understand it, but I really like it. It's kind of a way to make the responsiveness a bit easier. Basically got it's mobile first, so you've got a container, and then anything above 640 pixels the columns turn up, which I can't show you because I haven't got any columns.
Scales up. Built for mobile and then scales up.
I should have done some columns actually, but you can at least see the logo gets a bit bigger again.
And that logo is JPEG, presumably?
It's a PNG.
Right.
Yeah. Again, this is probably something that I could do as a SVG.
Yeah.
It's so graphic based rather than. I've also got the fonts changing size. Which again is all controlled in this typography folder, SAS file. I've got media queries, each one. Oh no, it's REMS, that's it. So I've got like a base project. I've got font size for desktop, 20 pixels. So all I need is this one media query for everything above 640 pixels, it scales up the base font size to 20 pixels. And then H1, H2, H3 follows in suit because it's all rems, which is always based on this font size. So I'm trying to work so that everything's reusable. That's the idea. Oh, and for the SAS, I bet I should do that as well, because it's quite nice. I've got everything, I've got Node running, like locally, and I just copied a copy code. This is basically how I'm converting SAS to CSS. Things that I don't really understand. I understand it. Yeah. It's basically finding anything in my SAS folder, and then anything in there that's an SCSS file, it's then changing to a CSS file and moving to my CSS.
And you've got a watch on that as well?
Yeah, and I've got a watch on that. So all I need to do is come here and run a gulp. And it's good because it also debugs my CSS as I'm doing it, which is nice.
I'll tell you when
they
finish then, and now I'm going to
draw. If I change this to 50% and then save, and it runs gulp, and then I load my main CSS file, which is the only thing that is actually the browser can understand, and that's got all of it, everything together. And if I can remember what I changed.
Logo.
Yeah, so there we go. Logo, 50%. It's taken that and so that's obviously served to the browser.
So is the SAS server running like in real time, or was it a one-time compile that you did?
It's running in real time. This file is watching for, so it's running locally, it's Node running JavaScript just nice. On my machine. Not on a server or anything, so I guess my machine is the server. And then, yeah, so it's...
If you were running this on a production site, would the SCSS files be converting?
Yeah, so you don't serve them, so yeah, that would be... You'd do your stuff and then you would only upload the CSS file to the server, so you wouldn't really see the CSS, that's all, the SAS, that's all in the background.
So in a real development environment, you'd only really be running the pre-compilation once.
Yeah. So all you'd see would be the CSS file. So on my index, I've done this really old school again. I was sort of thinking about looking at PHP frameworks and everything, but in there just went for one index file for now. But you can see that all I asking for is CSS main.css, so that's all, it's just all in one, so it's quite nice that I only have to come back to one file. And I just change the JavaScript for the runtimes, which I try to do as much on my own as possible.
No jQuery.
Yeah, no jQuery, so that I can understand it a bit more. So I'm basically just changing opacity on the scroll. So when I've scrolled 500 pixels, is it pixels? some stuff happens. And then padding as well for the roll left. And then again at 700, I reveal that text. So there's basically two things happening there. Here that padding goes along and it appears at the same time. And then a bit further there's
really cool effect, man.
Yeah,
it does all look really smart and really
cool. Yeah, that's all. I mean, that was my main focus
in a way. I can tell you're a designer.
Good, well, I'm happy about that. Yeah, cool. I think that's it.